I'd like to give all glory and praise and honor unto the Most High. And we're going to get into it today, man. And I'm going to probably be all over the place. You know what I mean? I'm going to be a little sporadic on this topic. You know, I'm going to dive into some other things. But, you know, what we're going to be talking about today is this brother right here. You know, this was, his name was MOE, I believe it was. And, you know, recently I've seen it all over the headlines that he passed, you know, and I didn't know who this brother was. But, you know, the only way I recognized him was from the Mike Tyson interview that him and Boosie just conducted, you know. That was just like a few weeks ago. Well, you know, that's how I recognized him, you know. And I was like, oh, snap, isn't that brother that I just recently kind of, that was in Mike Tyson video sitting next to Boosie? So that's how I recognize where he was from, man. And his brother passed, you know, in a shootout. I guess there was a shooting, and he got caught up. You know, and it's sad, man, because I mean, like I was saying in the other video too. You know, there can no good come to, you know, those that's always occupied in evil. And you see right here, this brother's throwing up. You know, the 666, you know, he sold out. And it's just been a slew of brothers, man, you know, that's just been popping up. You know, you just had some other brother named King Von, you know, that passed. You had some other brother, and you know, like maybe about a month or two ago, named FGB Duck, you know, that passed. And it's like, damn, bro. And it's all the same way, man, you know. And, you know, and you see the same thing, you know, you see people, you know, crying and, oh my God, we need to stop killing each other. We need to stop doing this. We need to stop doing that. You know, same thing over and over again. We gotta stop doing this. You know, but when we presented you guys the solution, you guys don't want to hearken onto that. You guys tried everything else, but turning back to the scriptures and turning back into the Most High, you know, striving for righteousness, man, you know. But you know that devil came to collect, man. You know some people have longer spans, some people got shorter spans, you know. But we're gonna get into the scriptures real quick, you know. And show you some of the solutions for this, man. Knowing whenever these brothers pass, I always go back and look at the music videos, you know, to see like what they was rapping about. You know, and it's always the same thing. You know, I'm a bust my gun. You know what I mean? I'm a jack this person. I'm a jack that. I mean, low vibrational type stuff, man. You know, shoot them, try me. You know what I mean, pop the ops and all this crap, man. All this nonsense, man. Carnal. Flashing money, you know what I mean? Talking about how they gonna dog this woman and that. You know, carnal stuff, man. Let's go to Proverbs 16:7. It says, when a man's way please the Lord, he maketh even his enemies to be at peace with him, man. You know? So when you're doing the will of the Most High and the Most High's pleased, your enemies will be at peace with you, man. And these guys are not serving the Most High. They're serving the devil. I mean, no wonder why these shootings keep happening. No wonder why you got so many enemies. I mean, no wonder why you never at peace. You know, because your ways are not pleasing the Lord. The Lord ain't about no that carnal mindset, popping guns and popping this and shooting your fellow brother down and blood sacrificing this person and that person. You know what I mean, selling each other out. That don't please the Most High, man. You know, so you always gonna have these enemies popping up because their ways is not pleasing the Most High. You know what I mean, who they pleasing is the devil, Satan. You know, and his little minions, when he see these guys flashing the money, talking about popping guns and popping this and popping that. You know I mean, that's what they attract. You know I mean, they're not pleasing the Lord, man. Oh man. Yo, this is crazy, man. I mean, the solutions is right here. Turn to the Most High. When you turn to the Most High, you know what I mean? Pick up your Bible, start reading it, changing your life. He's gonna severe that. He's gonna put that line in between you, you know what I mean, and your enemies, you know, and those that's carnal minded. You know me? They don't want nothing to do with the scriptures. They don't want nothing to do, you know, with the Most High. So they're gonna have to go another way, man. You know, and find somebody else to strive with. So, man. But when your ways don't please the Most High, like I said, your enemies is gonna rise up. I mean, and that's what's been happening over and over and over again. And he's not gonna be the last one to go through something like this, man. You know, the two-thirds been getting cut down, man. You know, because they don't care about nothing. You know? And they don't care about their own fellow brethren. Let's look at Proverbs 3, verse 30. Strive not with a man without cause if he had done thee no harm. Yeah. I mean, a lot of you guys attract that energy to you, man. You know what I mean? Because you want to go out there and strive with men and they haven't done you anything. And the perfect example of that is these Masons and these gang stalkers and all that, you know, too. They want to strive with men, start conflict. I mean, with people they never even met, and expect you know, positivity to come to them. You know, strive not with a man if he had done you no harm, man. And a lot of these guys, man, they invite that thing. They invite that negativity to them, man. You know what I mean? They go out looking for trouble, and that's, like I said, that's the demons in them, man. That's doing that. You mean? That's the carnal mindset in them, man. That's always out for strife, man, with another person. And they haven't, you don't know this person from, you know, from Jack Spit. You don't know him. You know? You never met him a day in your life, or her. But you constantly coming out striving, you know, to create conflict so you could get a rise out of them. You know? All that stuff is gonna come back to you, man. You know? You know, and what we're going to take a look at right now is Numbers chapter 22. And we're going to be looking at Balaam and Balak. So, and the reason we're looking at Numbers 22, because it shows you, you know, how the enemy, you know, they can't touch us, you know, and these you know, the powers that be understand this. They understand the scriptures, man. You know? They understand it, and they put these scriptures into use, into conquering us. You know what I mean? So, and I'm going to get into more detail after I read it. It says right here, and Balak the son of Zippor saw all that Israel had done to the Amorites. And Moab was so afraid of these other people because they were many. And Moab was distressed because of the children of Israel. And Moab said unto the elders of Midian, now shall this company lick up all that are round about us, as the ox licketh up the grass of the field. And Balak the son of Zippor was king of the Moabites at that time. Amen. He sent messages therefore unto Balaam the son of Beor to Pethor, which is by the river of the land of the children of his people, to call him, saying, behold, there's a people come out from Egypt. Behold, they cover the face of the earth, and they abide over against me. Come now, therefore, I pray thee, curse me this people, for they are too mighty for me. Preadventure, I shall prevail, that we may smite them, and that I may drive them out from the land, and I will, that he whom thou blessed is blessed, and he whom thou cursed is cursed. So this is pretty much, you know, Balak, you know, he's going to this Balaam, you know, who's known for, you know, blessing and cursing people. He wants them to curse the Israelites, man. You know, there's a group of people that's the Israelites. Why? Because he's afraid of them. He's seen how powerful they were. He's seen that these people were too mighty. So look, we gotta do something, man, because these people are gonna overtake me. Curse them. Curse these people, Balaam. So let's keep going. I think it's the next one is numbers 20:23. So I'm not gonna read the whole thing. I'm just gonna, you know, pretty much the Most High told Balaam, look, don't you can't curse these people. And right here in verse 8, it says, how shall I curse whom God hath not cursed? Or how shall I defy whom the Lord has not defiled? You mean? So Israel, I mean, they weren't allowed to be cursed because the Most High blessed them, man. You know? And what happened is the enemy understand it. So what they do, you get them to curse themselves. You mean? Because you can't curse what the Most High's blessed. You get them to curse themselves. And this is where the powers that be come in, because they understand this. You mean? So what they do, you know, is they look for the basis of our people. You know, the basis, the lowest, you know, and they elevate them and they give them power, they give them money. You know what I mean? They make them famous. You mean? To promote their lawlessness and their baseness. Because why? Because they're base too. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? And who? Like, you know, those fake Jews that's running the industry, I mean, they're base too. You know? So they, you know, so they're looking for other base people just like them. You know what I mean? Bases of men. They come in here and promote all lawlessness and all manner of wickedness. Why? Because that's gonna cause the people to curse themselves, man. I mean, and then they could be conquered. That's why you got all these niggas talking about shooting and robbing and jacking and stealing and shooting guns and all this stuff and all manner of lawlessness, man. It's putting curses on us. You mean? And they're highly esteemed, you know? And to be honest with you, these guys ain't nothing but the king's jesters. You know what I mean? So you see, this is like, you know what a jester is, you know what I mean? A jester is somebody that, you know, they entertain the king. When the king call, look, I want my jester. He come in there and he's clowning and he's doing all type of stupid stuff to impress the king, man. You mean? So that's what a lot of these guys are, you know, in the eyes of the powers that be. They're jesters. They need entertainment. You know what I mean? The king needs entertainment. So he needs jesters. He don't want nobody that's serious. He needs jesters, man. That's going to dance and coon and buck dance to him. You know what I mean? This examples of jesters. You know, look at that. Look at the king laughing while a jester just clown for him. That's what they want. And that's basically what these guys are, you know, that's promoting all manner of lawlessness, man. Justice for the king, the powers that be. You know what I mean? And Esau, and they get paid well. They was getting paid well back then, the king's jester. And they're getting paid well here today, man. And, you know, Esau love his jesters, man. Let's take a look at this clip real quick, man.
Oh, shit.
He's yours to ride.
Me? I haven't been totally honest to you about who I am.
Oh?
I'm not only the Duke's official messenger, but I'm also the court jester.
Messenger and jester. An odd combination of talents.
Bring him on.
That is fun.
Damn.
Oh.
So the king loved his jesters, man. You see how happy they were when he started, like, you know what I mean, cooning and buffooning? You know what I mean? And they get paid well, and that's what, like, you know what I mean? A lot of these rappers are with their based activity, man. You know? They're jesters to these guys, you know? You know what I mean? Like I said, they took the basis of our people and made the activity, I mean, the lawlessness, popular. You know? They made it respectable. You know? People want to be like them. You know? People are influenced like them. I mean, people are looking up to these guys. People are following in their footsteps because they understand the scriptures. Promote the bases of their men and let them curse them. I mean, they curse the rest. You know? Man, that's why, you know, Balaam was saying, I can't curse them. I mean, but what they do, they allow them to curse themselves. You know? You know, and another perfect example of how they show you that they love jesters, man. They love people that love to sing and the telling of Israel, especially Judah, you know, because Judah, you know, is the praises, you know. You know, the head tribe. Psalms 137:3. For there are they that carried us away captive required of us a song, and they that wasted us required of us mirth, saying, sing us one of those songs of Zion, man. You know? Mirth. Mirth is like entertainment, man. Entertain me. Sing us one of your songs, man. You mean? This is when they was in captivity. You mean? The enemy was telling this to them. You know? Because the king loved jesters, man. He loves his jesters, man. You know? You got to buck dance for the king, man. You mean? For them butter biscuits. You don't want nobody serious around him. Let's take a look at this clip from Uncle Tom's Cabin. I believe that was the movie. You know, because they show you the truth in these movies, man.
Sit over there where you belong.
Man gave you money for clothes for us. What'd you do? Drink it?
Mr. Legree got all kind of clothes on the plantation. Off of all the slaves that died. Get out! What is the funeral? What do you think they're all saying about you up there? If you behave yourselves, you'll be treated well, and if not, look out. You understand each other? Well, answer.
Yes, sir.
All right. Now, let's hear you sing a song. Sing whatever you want to. Sing one of those spirituals. All right? Why don't you sing? Sing, I said.
Oh, Mississippi, many you have seen. Oh, Mississippi, good friends we have been. Oh, you know my yearning, burning in my heart. And you know my sadness when we part.
You know, so you see what the slave master wanted from him? He wanted them to sing one of the Negro spirituals, man. Psalms 137:3. For they that carried us away captive required of us a song, man. And entertainment to sing songs. And now, in this modern day society, now, this day and age, they're looking for the basis of our people. You know? And they promoting these guys, man. And these guys are placing curses on all of us. They selling out to Satan, you know? And they just cursing us, man. I mean, and they don't turn back to the Most High. I mean, hey, that cycle is going to continue. You know what I mean? And like I said, they doing everything except turning back to the scriptures, man. You know? Oh, man, the two-thirds, they don't care, man. They don't care, you know? And Edom knows that. Esau knows that. You're talking about a people that sold out their own you know, our old Messiah, man. You know, to the Romans and stuff, you know what I mean? You know, for a base man like Barabbas. You know, it wasn't all our people, but the majority of them was base. That's why they chose Barabbas. They love wickedness, man. You know? They chose a base man over a righteous man. You know? Oh, man. The two-thirds, man. Let's take a look at this. Another person, man.
My job was stealing everybody's iPhone around school and jailbreaking them bitches. Like, I make them bitches mine, and then I sell them bitches. I get a locked iPhone. I get a lock. You know the iCloud lock? I steal the phone, iCloud lock it, sell it to your ass lock. Then you gotta give me the phone back, cause you gonna think I'm gonna unlock it for you. Then I'm gonna drive off. Keep doing it. I made like $1,800 a week off that shit. I ain't had no job. I used to finesse all the little kids who like smoking weed and doing them crazy ass shrooms and all that. I used to get mushrooms out the fucking ground, wrap them bitches up, fake ass acid. Used to just get paper and draw on it. Sell it to him for like $90 and shit. I ain't never had.
You know, 2 Edges 5:8 says menstruous women shall produce forth monsters, man. Menstruous women shall produce forth monsters, man. You know? And when the powers that be see somebody like him, they foaming at the mouth. They want him. They want somebody base like him. You heard what he says, man. You know what I mean? Stealing people's phones and things like that when he's fully capable of working. You know, he was proud to do it, and like I said, it wasn't necessarily about him stealing. You know, it's about look how prideful he is. You know what I mean? In doing it, man, he has no remorse. You know what I mean, I think his name is YMW Melly or something like that, and you gotta pay attention to these guys, man. You know what I mean, and how they act and how they move. Because this same guy right here is locked up now, you know, for killing two of his friends, man. You know what I mean? So pay attention to these guys, man. Oh, jack this guy, jack that guy. Showing no remorse for what they've done, man. You know, he's in jail right now for murder, for killing two of his friends, man. So-called friends. That was, you know what I mean? That was in a car with him. You know? And you can tell that something's off with this guy, man. He's possessed. You know what I mean? Because it ain't really about stealing. Let's hold on. Let me bring that verse up. Proverbs 6:30. It says, "Men, do not despise a thief if he steal a satisfied soul when he's hungry." You know what I mean? You know, so you know, if you in dire need of it, man, like, yo, that's your last resort. You know what I mean? You don't got nothing else. Like, look, the scripture says, look, no, thou shalt not steal. But like it says right here, don't despise a thief if he's a thief to satisfy his soul when he's hungry, man. You know what I mean? This needs to be, you know, applied in a proper context. You know? Not some nigga, you know what I mean, that's just doing it because he's lazy. You know, and he's not remorseful. And you see what his actions lined up, you know, and where he's at right now. You know what I mean? Like I said, when they see people like this, oh man, they foaming at the mouth to put them on a platform. I mean, so they can spread their wickedness, man. You know? Their ways are not pleasing the Lord, man. They got the praises of men. Proverbs 18:21, man. Life and death are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof, man. You know what I mean? So people say sticks and stones could break my bones, but words don't ever hurt me. I mean, but that's not necessarily true, man. You know what I mean? Because words are powerful, man. I mean, words are powerful. I mean, when they say thou shalt not kill, it's not always talking about physically killing somebody. You know, I mean, you could kill people with your words, man. I mean, you ever see those kids on the internet? You know what I mean? They getting cyberbullied and they go and they kill themselves and jump over a bridge or something like that. I mean, yeah, they were you know, weak, you know, mentally. But you know, those words still was powerful, man. You know, so the energy that these guys are putting out, you know, it's powerful. And it's placing curses, you know, on a lot of people and on themselves, man. You know? But they're going to have to answer for every word, man. Every word. You know, and I just want to segue into Beyonce real quick. I mean, into another topic. And you know, this pissed me off, man. I mean, because this witch right here, you know, this was the day, you know, of elections. And she's telling people to go vote, you know, while she's doing the one-eye symbolism, man. I said, man, which is once again showing you she knows the truth, but that she's down with the deception, man. You know, that just pissed me off, man. You know, and I had to segue into this real quick. I mean, this is another sellout. I mean, and you could be elegant in a sellout too. You know what I mean? It ain't always about the basis of our people. You could have a form of elegance and still be base. And a perfect example is that you look at John Legend's wife, you know what I mean? With the whole, I mean, pedophilia thing. Chrissy Teigen with the whole Pizzagate and the things she was tweeting about the kids. Yes, she looked good. She may have a form of elegance and, you know, be highly esteemed. But look at what she's about, man. So you can still be elegant and based. I mean, if you get what I'm saying. You know? So, we're going to leave with the words from, Pastor Omar, man.
We as a people have not come to full grips with the fact that we sold out our Savior. We have not come to the revelation that it was our hands, that it was our mouth, it was our heart that turned on the Son of the living God, and we need to come to grips with that. We need to, like them children say, we need to own it. It was us. But Pastor, it was the Romans who sold him into the hand of the Romans. That's why this series, Minister, is called How We Sold Out Our Savior. And the problem is, Malvo, we still selling each other out to this day. And it's my belief, as we as a people come to grips that we sold out the very best that was born amongst us, Yahshua HaMashiach, the God-man, the fullness of the Godhead bodily. We even sold him out who looked like us. When we come to grips with that, I think that revelation will stop us from selling out one another. You see? We need to come to grips.
No, true words, man. So when we could come to grips with that, and that we gave up the best amongst us, man. You know, and they know that, man. They powers that be know that. That's why they use the same tactic over again. You know me? They get that Judas, man. Cause they know us, man. I don't say all of us, but they know our people, man. Greed, 30 pieces of silver, man. They'll do it, and they sit back and just laugh. It's all entertainment for them. That's all it was, man. I mean, just like this whole gang stalking thing, it's just people suffering, but for them, it's entertainment for them, man. You know? Oh, man. I mean, even you niggas that sold out, I mean, they laughing at you. I mean, damn, he really gave her up? He really gave him up? Oh, man. These guys sell out for cheap. We get them for cheap, man. Because you're not prudent and you don't see the bigger picture, man. You know? All praises to the Most High, man. Hopefully this was edifying, man.